asking there, and the green light is on. Oh, and Zegar moved again there, but the referee has allowed it to continue. And now here comes Seyfudinov around the outside, but Zegar's leaving. Oh! Seyfudinov have had their treatment, and indeed we just really hope that they both get up from this. Here we see it again, Kelvin.
Yeah, Seyfudinov's coming around the outside, but he isn't quite there, and Zegar comes across to stop that move, and unfortunately, that's the issue. That is the issue, and Andreas Johnsson, who's made a poor start, he's out the back.
Emil Seyfudinov is just getting to his feet.
And boom, catches the side of him, side swipes in. And his left arm and wrist and hand area certainly taken really heavy impact. Not the ideal start for him. Zegar there just lifting and runs out of room. Tough speedway. Wouldn't want to be the referee.
Race coming up. Can Hancock win it? Will Holder, the reigning champion, do it? Vasilik's made a beauty off the inside. Hampel's gone down.
Phoenix to be all four back here, I would think. It was just a classic case of Ryder there. Holder just straightening up momentarily to avoid Hancock, and Hampel just runs out of room. Hampel just has not been at the races tonight. Whether last year's crash is playing on his mind, must have come into this meeting in top form. He won the previous Grand Prix. It looks a bit down and out there, and he's just got the 1 point from his ride so far this evening, so can't make the semi-final.
Heat 17, what can Woffenden do off the inside? He's made a good start, but Iversen off two, magnificent. Now Woffenden is going to try and take him out wide here. Iversen around the outside, great move, and here comes Holder! Great move up the inside from Chris Holder. Iversen with the lead, Holder on the inside, Woffenden is third, and Holder!
Oh, pushing so hard, Woffenden back in third place, Iversen! Woffenden on the inside, third to first, wonderful move from the British rider. Holder now in second place. Iversen can't believe what's just happened. He's been relegated to third place. Fabulous ride from Woffenden.
Where on earth did he get that from? Absolutely unbelievable. Right place, right time, and one lap to go. Ty Woffenden, the race leader. Oh, Iversen's gone down!
And then he really rides a storm around in front. Iversen really frustrated, then gets far too much grip. Bike gets away from him. He buries himself in the bottine.
Hancock's made a good start off the inside, but Seyfudinov's there as well. Seyfudinov has the lead, and Lindgren's off the bike.
Oh. Out there, and it just grabs hold of the back wheel and literally cannot hang on to the bike. Seyfudinov and Hancock, but look at, he's on the back wheel, he just cannot control the bike. He's gone from a slick surface into grip, the bike just rears up underneath him, and he rushes into the air fence at high speed. You're dead right, Nigel, he's still on the motorbike, you watch it now, lifts up there, bike speeds up, and boom, into the safety fence.
Odjeżdżają, jak szybkie włoskie pociągi, będzie tam kraksa. Na razie jak pięknie przedarł się Emil Seyfudinov, Ty Woffenden odrabia Tański w tym bezpośrednim pojedynku, jeden punkt. Woffenden przed Emilem, a teraz jeszcze wjeżdża. Tutaj Nils Christian Iversen robi wspaniałą robotę. Tajowi upadek, upadek, ach, miał kolejną szansę wygrania startu z Woffendenem.
Podniosło, podniosło.
A jak odprostowało. Ja nie wiem, czy nie jest tam, czy nie zerwało tam łańcucha, wiesz? Chciałbym to zobaczyć jeszcze gdzieś na zwolnionym.
Nie, 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 podniosło, podniosło przednie.
W tym gasku Nikola Kowarty. I Golob w końcu rozstawia tutaj, zacznie rozstawiać rywali. Nie, ale mamy upadek. Już Tomek Gazga.
Kompetencje, że możemy z arbitrem, z Jimem Lorenzem rozmawiać sobie o różnych sprawach, w różnych okolicznościach. Jim zupełnie spokojnie otworzył książkę, o której mówiłem, o tym nadrzędnym dokumencie w stosunku do regulaminu Grand Prix. To jest regulamin Komisji Wyścigów Torowych. Co tutaj się stanie, Paweł? Jeszcze tylko powiedzmy.
No chyba musi być wykluczony Kowaty, gdyż
tak,
no, nie opanował.
Bo zaatakował z tyłu tutaj tylne koło.
Koniecznie chciał.
Żółty kask, pole zewnętrzne, to jest Martin Waculik, Tomasz Golob, dobry dojazd, wiezie szeroko wywiózł Emila Seyfudinova. Marcen jest na prowadzeniu, co teraz zrobi Golob? Golob szerokie wejście, ale goni tutaj Emil, ale jemu akurat przeszkodzi Marcen. Marcen oszprycował Emila Seyfudinova. Tomasz Golob nie jest jakiś tutaj ekstremalnie szybki, wyjeżdża teraz za szeroko, tam wyprostowanym takim motocyklem szosowo, bo banda była już bardzo blisko, trzeba było się jakoś z tego uratować. Tomasz Golob, teraz Emil Seyfudinov przyczajony tam bardzo blisko płotu na drogim wirażu. Rozpędza się za Tomaszem Golobem, teraz upadł.
bliski, zaufany kolega, pan tajski Wofinder.
No tak jak tutaj odczytali ten taki uśmiech na twarzy Emila nasi komentatorzy, no potwierdziło się to w tym wyścigu, było bardzo nerwowo, tam parokrotnie był już na granicy upadku Emili, tutaj uślizg tylnego koła i
trzecim, a to wybrał za chwilę Jarosław Kampel i z zewnętrznego jedzie być może przyszły indywidualny mistrz świata, spada na pierwszym wirażu, a no dlaczego? Wypuścił za wcześnie motocykl, tak Adasiu?
No został zamknięty przez Wofindena, tutaj widzimy dorwał się, to jego tylnie koło dorwało się do tej nawierzchni takiej bardzo chropowatej.
Tam jest taka dziura tutaj jedna i właśnie w nią wpadł taka wyżłobiona jakby, to nawet nie jest kolejna, to jest taka oderwane. Tries the inside line. He's going to have to settle the third here, and now he's going to go wide. The lead is with Andreas Johnsson. Oh, it goes off! Oh dear! It's run away. Let's see it again here now.
Charging into turn three, he's trying to get up the inside, but gets a little bit of grip just as Golub turns the bike hard and runs in the back of him, and they effectively lifts over, and they do fall very heavily indeed. Just there momentarily, gets a lot of grip and just climbs all over the back of him. He slams into the track, and I would suggest that he may well.
Scandinavian Speedway Grand Prix. Oh, very, very shaky start there, and now.
Oh, he's
all over the place. Iversen has the lead. Wofinden really tried to jump the start there, you feel. Here comes the inside in yellow, Niels Christian Iversen. And now Wofinden is trying to come around the outside of Alice Drimmel. He's got past Alice Drimmel now. Now he's going to try and get up the inside of Iversen. The battle is on, but the lead here is with Martin Vasilik. But that was a start from Wofinden, Kelvin, where could easily have been pulled back.
Very much so. He was moving there and is a very tentative opening lap, but I sense he's settling into the race. He's working the inside line.
Oh.
Beginning to gain in confidence. Three abreast down the back straight. Iversen in second place. Vasilik just hanging on. Oh, Wofinden lifts again. He was out of shape early in the race, but all of a sudden now he can ride the motorbike. He's getting involved.
Oh, the lead. Vasilik has gone wide, and that allows. Oh, Vasilik's gone down on the back straight. The lead here now is with Niels Christian Iversen, and all of a sudden, Wofinden is going to collect 2 points.
Action out in front, Vasilik getting it all wrong, clipping the air fence, piling over the handlebars, and he also could be in trouble as well with a heavy fall late on in the race. Can't quite believe what we're witnessing here this evening. It's quite dramatic. Iversen then is
getting number 10.
Yeah, he's just got too much grip there. Possibly bike set up a little bit too aggressive, but I would suggest it's literally there. There's a rut there, and it's dug in, and it leaves right. Loves to win from the inside for sure.
Beat number 18 it is, and Wofinden's made a good start. Oh, Patterson's gone.
Wofinden on the inside. I was keenly looking at him, but Zagar's had a disappointing night. Just a little bit of contact there. Zagar allowing the bike to run across in front of Patterson. Referee Jim Lawrence can easily put all four back in here. Doesn't have to make any real exclusion because he could suggest that in his first corner bunching, but
Zagar, all four back, Kelvin.
Zagar does allow the bike to run across in front of Nicky Pedersen, but all four back, probably the right decision.
Yep, all four riders back for the restart. This the incident.
Yeah, Zagar does let the bike run across in front of.